colleagues, friends. I had, for the last 2 years at least, stopped thinking about higher education. So when I was asked to come here and I came to know about RUSA, my first reaction was, well, another committee, another commission or whatever. But I think we should not be so skeptical. Any opportunity we have to latch on to make sure that our country does well in the area of higher education. All of us sitting here have benefited from whatever education system has been created in this country. We wouldn't be all sitting in this hall if we did not have opportunities to go to a school, to go to a university, and so on. So we are ourselves examples of the benefits of education. But I must level with you and tell you that I'm really very confused on what we really want. And if my intervention here appears to you to be confused, I think it will be a genuine reflection of where, how I feel and what I think about what we are doing and where we are going. You know, when I was Vice Chancellor, I kept on doing my scientific work, and that's why I never wanted to go out of Delhi. But I participated in almost all the deliberations and meetings on higher education reforms very diligently, to the best of my ability. We had Knowledge Commission. Some of the meetings I also took part in. Some of the very eminent people on the panel of Knowledge Commission. Yashpal Committee, Professor Yashpal, all with all the members came to Delhi University. We had a lot of interaction. And there were some very intelligent people on that committee. UGC's Empowered Committee, I was a member. I spent many, many hours drafting that. Professor Nanam's name was mentioned here. He was chairing that committee. Our Science Academy's report, a wonderful document, not government sponsored, but first time India's academies had come together to give a document to the country, to the government. Vice Chancellor's Committee. Some of these vice chancellors, believe you me, are members of the National Science Academies, Third World Academy, some of the most bright people that we have. Madhav Menon Committee for IIT's, Rama Rao Committee, Kakodkar Committee, large number of committees. And I think if we are serious, we can sit for 5-10 days and put up another document based on these committees and give it to the government. Now, what's missing? The missing thing is that we want painless surgeries. We want nothing, nobody's domain should be challenged. Nobody should needs to work hard. But we just bring about a miracle without sweating on achieving it. So I think one of the things that we should be very clear about is what outcomes we want. Is it by intervention in each and everything, or is it showing up by example? For example, a very creditable step which the government took was opening new IITs, IIMs, central universities. Now, my view would be, make the central universities as the most happening places for education in the country. Stop worrying for a moment about the state universities. Let them be the kind of universities which will give you PhDs, faculty which will go to state universities and improve the standards of the state universities also. We need examples. We have in IITs and IIMs, and I have made this point earlier and I will make it today. Most of India's talent is going to come out from IITs and Indian Institute of Science Education, which have ICERs, which have been developed new, because they have made well-rounded curricula, they have been given some money and facilities, and they have reasonable faculty. It could be even better, but they have reasonable faculty. And therefore, these are going to be your stars, which will provide faculty to other universities and institutions. The other thing is to spread despondency and spread lack of quality everywhere. So I think the central government, please forgive me for this contrarian view, the central government should concentrate on a few institutions and make them the leading institutions which can compete with the best in the world. And that will give us the talent to that would get seeded in the private universities, in the public universities, in industry, everywhere. Now, what's happening with the central universities? Some of them are very old. They are a little bit bogged down by depletion of grants. For many, many years, they did not receive any money. And we kept on opening new institutions. You know, it's a very hard fact that we have not followed the models which other countries have followed in developing their universities. In fact, we took research out of Indian universities and created specialized institutions to do even basic research. Applied research, you need institutions. You cannot do space research in a university. But for basic research, we have created institutions. And the faculty there, the scientists there don't teach. And we don't have that much talent that we can have hundreds of institutions and hundreds of good universities. We don't have that kind of talented faculty. So I think we should focus on outcomes. We should focus on developing some quality in selected institutions and compete with the world. And those teachers, those scientists will go into our industry, into our new universities, into our state universities, and that is the way to build up things. Now, the other point I would like to make is, you know, if you want to make RUSA have an impact, please involve the Ministry of Science and Technology. You know, we tell universities, bring everybody together. You move from one course to the other. But in the ministries themselves, we are reluctant to talk across the ministries. Now, what is great about the world-class universities? They have excellent research. And research requires competitive funding grants, not handouts. You compete for those grants and the best get the money and push forward the frontiers of knowledge. Now, what are we doing about that? Without science and technology, in fact, if we want to raise the status of these state universities, they require research funding. Any faculty which does not carry out any research has no incentive to think about what is new, and if you are not thinking about new, you would like to keep on teaching what you learned when you did your PhD or your MA, MSc. What's the incentive for you to learn new? That is because you have a research challenge. So, without the science and technology ministry's intervention, we will not be able to raise the standards of Indian universities. They'll keep on opening their own institutions, because they don't feel involved. So if you are really serious, in fact, in France, they made the Minister of Higher Education Education, the Minister of Science and Technology also. Same ministry. But we are compartmentalized. We want universities to open up their compartments. We want faculty to be compartment, but we don't want to work across ministries. I think something needs to be done on that. The last point I would like to make is even in faculty improvement, new IITs. I believe the new IITs should have been seeded by PhDs from abroad, from Caltechs and MITs of this world. Why am I saying that? Every country did it. China did it in a big way. Japan did it under the Meiji Revolution. Korea did it in a big way to build their engineering schools, to build their universities. You need fresh air. You need new ideas. You cannot be 20 years behind. But we have not sent a single person, a single young Indian abroad to do PhDs in areas where we are weak. So where is the desire to take some new initiatives? And believe you me, these are not new. These are time-tested initiatives which we are reluctant to take. And I don't know why. Also, this whole idea about universities opening up to all kind of courses and all that. Why it's not happening? The young people would like to go and take a course. If some physics guy wants to learn a little bit on music, well, open up your doors and allow him or her to take a course in that. There's nothing very big. But what is big is even a country like the United States, which started this whole thing of liberal education, four-year courses, you can take any course wherever you like, are talking today about strength in STEM, science, technology, engineering, mathematics. Let's think about that. How do we bring our children up to the global standards in science, technology, engineering, and mathematics? If a student is good in language, a student is good in maths, that young person can do anything, any subject. And therefore, let's not forget the basics. I am all for opening up. Why we are not opening up? You know, in my own university, in Delhi University, why can't we open up? Because there is a workload problem. Because you don't want to be in the college after 1 o'clock. You said these kind of, and these things have to be challenged. And that requires some courage of conviction that we are not going the right way. A teacher has to spend more time. A student has to spend more time. There has to be more passion, better practicals. These are all well-known things. It's nothing new. So my request would be that if we are interested in that, I have not read, I will certainly read about what Roussa's outlines are. And I'm sorry that I've come a little bit unprepared on what Roussa is. By all means, we should think of improving state universities. We should think about improving village schools. We need to bring excellence in everything that we do in our lives. And we need to bring transparency. These things have been talked about every meeting that I go to. So I think the time is to take the bull by the horn and say, these are the weaknesses. These will have to be plugged. And I think without research, without competitive grant system, without a strong competitive grant system, the universities will keep on languishing. New institutes will be, they will keep on opening them, specialized institutions, specialized universities. That's not the way to go. There are brilliant global models. We should not be afraid to learn from them. We have our committees which have made excellent recommendations. And I want to say this once again, and then I will end then. These were very talented people who have given these recommendations. You don't have more talent. The same people will come back into new committees. It keeps us all busy. But we are not able to hit that bullseye of bringing excellence, creating new faculty, seeding in research in our universities. That is where the action is, and I think hopefully, I also hope against hope that we will do something about it. Thank you.